Brothers and sisters, today is one of my most favorite saints ever. I first discovered him really in the writings of Ralph Martin's book, The Fulfillment of All Design. I'm speaking about one of the great doctors of the church, St. Bernard of Clairvaux. St. Bernard is the most intriguing kind of character. Recently in a course that I just did with Father Paul Murray on the humanity of the medieval mystics, we looked even at just Bernard's humanity. You know, he was a man who was so emotional and affectionate, yet sober, reasonable, rational. But in his writings, they're so full of colorful language and texture. And he's not afraid to vent his emotion for God and for others. When his blood brother died, he wrote this most amazing eulogy that he was literally crying in the pages, you know, showing that incredible human love that becomes real from the impact of divine love in our own souls. You know, as more God comes into our hearts, St. Bernard would say that we become more truly human, we become more truly affectionate in the right ways. We start to show real warmth and love. But yet at the same time, Bernard had a temper and he was a saint. You know, the saints are not plaster Paris. They're humans just like us. Many of them carried their tempers or their weaknesses. You know, they had weaknesses. Even though their eyes were fixed on God, they were trying to become holy. They were sinners and they had weaknesses. And they had weaknesses right up until they died. And sometimes we can forget that. And if we forget that, we can become discouraged. Because we want to become saints. We have to become saints. That is an imperative by God. I mean, otherwise we won't make it to heaven. So it is for us to become saints, these living icons of Jesus Christ on earth. And St. Bernard, as I said, had this temper. Like one in this letter to, in one of the descriptions, there was a young man, I think it was his nephew, was at the monastery. By the way, when St. Bernard arrived to found his monastery, he arrived with some of his brothers, cousins, people. He arrived with like 30-something people. He was so persuasive. He arrived basically with a whole monastery community. And anyway, one of the men who came to the community that he founded, the monastery that he founded, went off to another monastery because Bernard was so hard on him. He vented his anger on him at one point, and then this guy was won over by another monastery and left. And so Bernard then totally cowered and humbled himself and literally went in search for the young man to bring him back to the monastery and just being totally repentant and humbled by it. So we see so much in St. Bernard's life. Above all, you know, Bernard is a man oozing with sacred scripture. You know, it just shows you that deep, deep monastic theology. He's a monk. And so the monastic spirituality, the monastic theology, the way of living out the scriptures, the way of thinking out the scriptures is full of the scriptures. So literally when you read St. Bernard's writings, you read all of his homilies, his sermons, you know, his books, they're full and dripping with his memory, full of the living word of God. He's living and eating the word of God and it's just pouring out of him. And so, but at the central part of his theology is really this whole idea of divine love. You could say divine love coming in search for us and us returning love for love. You know, us loving and drinking from the source, which he sees as God, the Holy Trinity, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, this Trinitarian exchange of love in all eternity, which is the bedrock of all of reality, the Holy Trinity. There's this love, this God is in fact a communion of love. And St. Bernard was there, so, you know, go in prayer to drink deep at the source of love so that one's earthly love, our love will be directed by this source and then be filled up from this source. So let's just see some things that Bernard has to say about love. He says, basically, I love because I love. I love that I may love. So love itself is the motive for loving. I love because I love. And he says, love is sufficient of itself. It gives pleasure by itself and because of itself. It is its own merit, its own reward. Love looks for no cause outside itself, no effect beyond itself. Its profit lies in its practice. I love because I love. I love that I may love. Love is a great thing so long as it continually returns to its fountainhead. So here he's speaking about God. You know, love is first of all rooted in God. Love follows God's words. love follows God's being. God is love. So not every affection and desire is actual love. It could be just that, desire or fallen desires or disordered affection. True love is desire and an affection, you could say, of the will to choose the good and to follow the way of God. In other words, to drink from the fountainhead, as St. Bernard would say. He says, love flows back to its source, always drawing from there the water which constantly replenishes it. Of all the movements, sensations, and feelings of the soul, love is the only one in which the creature can respond to the Creator and make some sort of a similar return, however unequal it may be. For when God loves, all he desires is to be loved in return. The sole purpose of his love is to be loved, in the knowledge that those who love him are made happy by their love of him. God wants us to love God because in doing that we come to our ultimate fulfillment.